just minimize the intake of sugar as best you can.
How?
There's a lot of obesity.
Mm-hmm.
And since that's what the information we've been given, that the sugar intake contributes to that, you just stay away from sugary foods as best you can.
Okay.
And just try to eat the foods that are, you know, mostly just what they call pure fruit. And it might not be so pure because of the poison that's in the very dirt, the soil that it comes from,
mm-hmm.
and all kind of chemicals and et cetera, that is supposed to be designed to kill insects, but it's also killing people. So you just eat those fruit and vegetables for the most part as best you can, right? Go to that counter and see what you can get. Tomatoes, avocados, spinach, broccoli, whatnot. But I hesitate, and I have done this down through the years, Neely Fuller, I mean, talking, when you start talking about nutrition, I hesitate to name the foods that I just named. Tomatoes, avocados, broccoli, cucumbers, spinach, kale. I could name those, but then I hesitate to even name those, even though I just did it. I hesitate to do so. Why? Because people have called me sometimes and said, can you say on the air what foods we should eat? You know, you're supposed to be talking about how to solve problems, and if food is a problem, Fuller, can you find out the foods that we should be eating and specify what they are? But I've always hesitated to do that for the simple reason that the white supremacists will listen to me say that. And if I have any credibility, and if other people have credibility, if every black person, black people who are in the nutrition business start saying, oh yes, eat broccoli, eat avocados, eat cucumbers, the white supremacists are listening to what you're saying, and they will just push a few buttons and start poisoning all of that. And make sure that it's available to black people. So like I said, starting off with this program, in the last few minutes that I've been on, talking about the nutrition, I just said, you just have to do the best you can with the prison food.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's no way to control the poison that's in it. It's all a guessing game. So if you happen to come across some food that you think may not be as poisonous as the rest of the food over from the other farm, whatnot, then you go with that. But always expect to be poisoned in whatever food that you're eating, because the white supremacists have complete control over all of the nutrition, quote unquote, that non-white people have access to, including the fish in the sea.
Mm-hmm.
They have control of that. They know just where to go to dump off all the waste and whatnot, all of the excess chemicals that come from factories and whatnot.
Yes.
And they'll dump it right off the coast of where black people are,
mm-hmm.
where they consider themselves kind of away from the maldoers. They'll say that, well, my island is kind of off the beaten track, so we know about racism and all like that. But it doesn't affect us because we're kind of away from the cities and all of the main traffic of the entire world. But the white supremacists know where that island is.
Mm-hmm.
And if they want to harm the people there, they'll just fly over it, dump waste, and call themselves trying to kill insects and all like that. And whatever they dump over the trees where the people get, they take their food from the trees. They'll just poison that because they'll poison the trees. So it just goes back to just one simple thing. We're prisoners of war. We have to eat the prison food. There isn't any other prison, any other food available. We're prisoners.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So we have to, you know, but you do the best you can. Just pick through the food. But they put the plate before you in the prison to say, well, all of it is a mess. But I'll just try to pick out the most nutritious part and just hope for the best.